Well, we're going to commence to welding the two sections of this swing set post together. I'm going to TIG weld like a root pass on there. Here's the material we'll be using for filler rod. It's basically a ER70S rod. So I'll set you up here and we'll start doing a little tack welding to keep our sleeves centered, and then we'll commence to doing the root pass. We'll check it for straight, how straight we are, and start our root pass. Now we'll slide it together and see. Get her straightened up, lined up. About as good a straight edge as I have around here. We could be a little bit lower right here in the joint. Clamp these ends down and see what it looks like. Raise this joint up a little bit. Shims underneath here, right at the joint. gonna check that one, see what it looks like. Tack that root in there. Well, got my welding done, got it all cleaned up, sanded off. There's a few undercuts in there, but like I said, I'm no pipe welder. I think it's plenty strong. It'll go a long ways to holding up the swing set. Anyway, that's it on this leg. Only thing left to do now is dig holes in the yard to put it in. Thanks for following along on this one. Bye. Well, we finished up fabrication on the swing set. Here's the three legs. They're 14 foot long. It'll be 4 foot in the ground and 10 foot sticking out of the ground. Here's the crossbars that the swings will mount on. We'll bolt those commercially available swing brackets on here, but and then they'll bolt to these mounts on the top of the pipes. But that's how they this is how they'll be going in the ground in this order. I got to try to get them the holes fairly level because the pipes are all the same length, so that's going to be the next challenge. Thank you. no pipe welder. Won't claim to be one, but this ought to hold. Get one on the other side. Just eyeballing it, looks pretty good. We'll continue around with these welds. I won't bore you with that whole process, but I'll bring you back when we're done. It's by the way, I'm using my Miller Synchrowave 180, sitting on about 170 amp, but doing a good job. This tubing really welds up nicely. I'll bring you back when we're done.